Now, again, we're going through the series in this vlog on seven principles. When presenting a wise and effective field to our authorities, we establish the fact that we're all under authority, everyone's under authority, and that there were questions that we need to ask ourselves, you know, about, you know, when we're going to go make an appeal. Go back and watch that from last week. Now, here's another principle, presenting a wise and effective appeal. Number two, have the right motives for your appeal. Have the right motive. Why are you making an appeal, okay? Your appeal should communicate your sincere concern for two aspects of your authority's leadership. I want you to let this soak in. Don't let this go over your head. This is very important. When you're making an appeal with your authority, then you should communicate your sincere concern, not just for yourself, but for two aspects for your authority's leadership. Number one, you need, this could, what you're going to appeal to him about is if he makes this decision, it might hurt his reputation. And so when you make an appeal to him, say, well, boss or pastor or mom or dad, I really think that this could ruin your reputation. Second thing is his goals. What are his goals? Not your goals, but his goals. And you're communicating him saying, if we do it this way, it's going to help you reach your goals and protect your reputation. Well, you know, a wife to her husband, she might say, you know, honey, listen, I don't think that we should do that because it really could hurt your spiritual reputation. What you could let your mind go. These are two things, obviously, that when you make an appeal, communicate sincere concern for these two aspects of your authority, his reputation, his goals, okay? Okay, the next one, third, is discern the appropriate time to make your appeal. Timing is everything. To determine the right timing for your appeal, you should ask these three questions. One, is my authority free to concentrate on my appeal right now? In other words, he's in the middle of something. I shouldn't be making an appeal then. Stop, make some time, let him be free to concentrate. The Bible says in Esther 7, 1 through 6, so the king and Haman came to banquet with Esther, the queen. And the king said again unto Esther on the second day at the banquet of wine, what is thy petition, Queen Esther? And it shall be granted thee. And what is thy request? And it shall be performed even to the half of the kingdom. And then Esther, the queen, answered and said, if I have found favor in thy sight, O king, and if it please the king, let my life be given me at my petition and my people at my request. For we are sold, and my people to be destroyed, to be slain and to perish. But if we have had sold for bondmen and bondwoman, I had held my tongue, although the enemy could not countervail the king's damage. And then the king Ahasuerus answered and said unto the queen Esther the queen, who is he and where is he that durst pursue in his heart to do so? And Esther said, the adversary and enemy is the wicked Haman. And then Haman was afraid before the king and the queen. And so she knew there was a timing involved in coming to him to making her appeal. And so to determine the right timing for your appeal, you could ask these three questions. We gave the first one. The second one is, will my authority understand that I am ready to make sacrifices in order for the appeal to be granted? Third, will my authority be able to count on my acceptance of his decision, even if he denies the appeal? You got to be able to go in there. If you're going to make right timing of your appeal, you got to be able to say, I'm willing to take whatever decision he makes. And if you do that, the next time you make an appeal, he'll know that. We'll take care of you next week on this, okay?